He's alive! Oh my goodness, I'm so happy! I knew he was coming back, and we'd heard reports that he was spotted on set. It made me so happy as I tweeted out just a few days ago. And in fact, my father loved the first Wonder Woman. I wish I had been recording him when I told him that Steve Trevor had been spotted on set. He just lit up like a Christmas tree. And I don't think that Patty Jenkins nor Chris Pine get enough credit for making Steve Trevor finally as indispensable to Wonder Woman as Lois Lane is to Superman. Oh, he's just such a great character. So good. In fact, he's so awesome that I almost missed this other pic that Patty Jenkins tweeted out this morning featuring Wonder Woman herself. Now, to be fair, it's a very faint picture of her, right? But still, I honestly feel they're co-stars of these movies. I think that you really couldn't make a movie without either one of them, to be honest with you. I think Steve Trevor is just that great a character. And I love that they're equals, they're partners. If you don't like Wonder Woman, we were just talking about this yesterday, I feel sorry for you. This is such an amazing property. It's so good. It's as good as like the Christopher Reeve, Margot Kidder, although those got progressively, well, I think, you know, the second Superman, well, I don't know. I'm not a huge fan of those movies, but I'm trying to appeal to those of you that are, because I really want this to succeed. So first off, let's talk about Wonder Woman, then we'll get back to Steve, right? We're gonna end on a strong note. So no 80s hair for Wonder Woman, obviously. I think that's a good choice. You want her to be taken seriously, and she's very serious, so is Steve, right? He seems to not like the 80s, although I think the ice cream next to him is a very nice, sweet nod. Sweet to the first movie, so I like that quite a bit. I'm glad they're serious because the pop culture references in her photo are surprisingly light. You know, I was hoping in my 1984 discussion for the title, and Patty Jenkins does confirm that it's called Wonder Woman 1984. Such a good title. I like it because it has a seriousness to it. You know, it's cooler. It's unique. It's not like Wonder Woman 2, which sounds so generic. And also, you know, Wonder Woman Returns, which they were considering because, of course, they've done Superman Returns and Batman Returns. I think this seems unique, and like they're, again, unique, and they're going to do something that you should pay attention to. That's what I like about it. It seems new, even though, of course, we're going back in time. But the two big obvious pop culture references there are J.R. Ewing from Dallas, and then that's Christie Brinkley from National Lampoon's Vacation, which came out just the year before. And I think the focus on media is very interesting. Perhaps they will go with Maxwell Lord. As you might recall, I said that was a slim possibility, but it's looking like a bigger and bigger one. Maxwell Lord, you know, he doesn't have to be a media titan, but it works. And he's a big part of the Wonder Woman mythos, thanks to that neck snap. So I don't know if I would redo The Purple Man, but you know what? Marvel Netflix shows are kind of going downhill. And, you know, Marvel, you know, what they did, because Batman v Superman was being done, Kevin Feige infamously greenlit Civil War. So let's try it. I don't know. Do you want to compete with David Tennant? I don't know. All right, but that's speculation. Let's talk about what's right before our eyes, and that's Steve Trevor, who continues to single white female Steve Rogers hardcore. But you know what? Whereas Steve Rogers, to me, is a giant wet blanket, Steve Trevor is oh so much fun. Maybe some of you don't like him because you're protecting Steve Rogers, right? You're like, Steve Rogers did it first. But I think Steve Trevor does it better. He looks so cool. I love, you know, look at the acting. You know, as they always say, a lot of acting is reacting. And there's just so much going on in this picture just with the expression on his face. I love it. Now, my only concern here is that it reminds me of a lot of other 80s-based properties that we've seen quite recently. For instance, the X-Men Apocalypse movie, and then Stranger Things, etc., etc. But he's back. That's all I need to know. Just like Diana, that's all we care about. But will he only come back to die again? Because he wasn't in Justice League, and she was still pretty bummed in that movie. She wasn't like, it's okay, he came to visit in the 80s. I'm sure he'll be back again someday, right? But maybe they'll just forget that Justice League ever happened, right? So how could this happen? How could he come back? I'm sure some of you were like, oh, how cheap, you know, he didn't stay dead. It's horrible. And, you know, I myself have said, like, for instance, Gamora had better stay dead, you know, at least for a single movie. But Gamora was in a lot of movies. We only got Steve for one. And I, quite frankly, I just don't think that you can make this movie without him. Again, as I said, I think he's as equally important to the character at this point. You know, it's like having Batman without Alfred, right? I mean, it's just that important. I think, although I think I prefer the Superman Lois Lane comparison. Although this one has no bad instances yet. This is, you know, hopefully they'll never recast these characters and they'll make these movies forever. It's so good. All right, so as for how he probably came back, can you tell I'm excited? So as for how he probably came back, you're dealing with Greek mythology. Of course he can return from the dead because all the dead are hanging out in Hades and they often get broken out or escape. Right? I hope, by the way, that Steve Trevor escapes. Again, I prefer him as Wonder Woman's partner, not a damsel in distress. He might have been brought back as like revenge to throw her off her game, but I don't know. I mean, I think you'd be like, if you knew them at all, you'd know that together they're stronger. Okay, I'm so excited. All right, so I'm also very happy they released both these images, which means that they're A, gonna play up Steve Trevor a lot in the marketing, which I think is very, very important, but it also means we're off to the races PR-wise, and that's with more images likely coming, building up to what I think is going to be a very, very good San Diego Comic-Con. Marvel's sitting it out this year, so it's Warner Brothers to lose. They always make a very good show at Comic-Con, and maybe they'll even have some kind of teaser for us. Oh, I'm so excited. I'm so excited. Are you as excited as I am? Share your thoughts down below. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos, including my Wonder Woman 1984 breakdown for as to why they potentially chose that year. Right now.